Hey guys, how's it going? Happy, I'm not even gonna say what day it is because who knows when I'll finally make this video public. But I just had this thought, and actually I've had this thought several times. Side note, this is one of the oldest little sweatshirts that I have from Reebok, and it is so funny because we went to visit Reebok World Headquarters, this is like 2 years ago, myself and about 12 to 15 of my Fitfluential ambassadors, and this little sweatshirt top thing is one of the favorite things for all of us. Like, it's so funny because every time I'll see some of those girls, we'll be at this event or that event and we'll be wearing this thing just like to wear around. I wear it in my house all the time. They don't make it anymore, which is so upsetting. Can't you hate that? Okay, anyway, one of the things that I realized, okay, so this is something I realized about myself, and I wanted to share it with you guys because I feel like so many of you, well, I know so many of you have been writing to me and saying, oh my God, you know, thanks for sharing this or that because I do the same thing, and I'm so glad that somebody else, you know, figured out how to get past it or whatever. The thing is, guys, I don't know if any of you have ever gone to see a therapist or whatever, and I had never gone to see a therapist until... when was this? And I'm dying to get started again because it's so helpful. It's so helpful to go to a therapist. Now, I know there's like three different types of therapists that you can go to. There's a counselor, a psychiatrist, and a psychologist. My understanding, if memory serves, which of course my memory doesn't always serve me, is that I believe a psychiatrist can prescribe medication. So I think that I went to a psychologist, or maybe it was a counselor. I'm not quite sure, but she was wonderful. And what's nice about going to see a therapist is it's somebody that has, obviously, they have no agenda other than to help you talk through stuff and figure stuff out. Furthermore, they're completely objective. So they don't know you. They don't know your drama. They're not maybe like a best friend who's just going to tell you, you know, we all have the types of friends that sometimes won't tell us the tough truth. Certainly I focus now on surrounding myself with people that will tell me not just what I want to hear. But anyway, when you go to see a therapist, the biggest thing that they do is it's wonderful because once you figure out what they do, you can do it with yourself. That sounded really awful. But a lot of what I'm sharing with you is just stuff that I talk myself through, a lot of stuff, and it's helped me to straighten myself out. It's helped me to get through tough times. It's helped me to move past bad habits. I mentioned in one of my last videos how I said I figured out that I had this thing, right? That it was just a bad habit of every time I got angry, I would immediately want to go out and get, you know, really bad cheat food. Now, those of you guys that have been watching my videos for a long time, you know, I didn't used to have a great relationship with food. I've had years and years of extreme dieting because, you know, again, I never was happy with myself. I was always very insecure. And of course, coincidentally, I didn't realize that I was dealing with these massive hormonal imbalances that were preventing me from getting the results that I want. So, you know, I kind of went to extreme measures. And when you diet so extremely, you know, then your cheat meals or your cheat days become these epic adventures, and you just become, you have an unhealthy relationship with food. I can say, no question, that today, excuse me, that was a hiccup. I could say that today I have a much better relationship with food, but I've also learned, whether it's food topics or relationship topics or work topics or dealing with people, anything, I've just learned to talk through things just like a therapist would do with you. So a lot of the stuff that I've shared with you guys, remember I shared with you that at the end of the year I had this aha moment. It was an aha moment about my attitude towards work, how I always felt so overwhelmed and so stressed out, kind of in this constant cycle of never being able to get out of it. I didn't, you know, it wasn't like a light switch that all of a sudden everything became clear to me. I thought it through. There was this process of me going, okay, why is it that I, you know, why am I so stressed? Because I kept going, I'm so stressed, I have so much anxiety, I could never get ahead. And so then I realized, okay, the reason that I have such a bad attitude, the reason that I never get ahead, and I just started kind of working back, you know, why do I feel like I'm never getting ahead? Well, I'm never getting ahead because I really don't focus. Why do I not focus? I don't focus because I don't really want to do this stuff. Why do I not want to do this stuff? Well, I don't want to do it because I feel like it's going to take so long. And then I started kind of talking myself through it and going, it really doesn't take that long, Kelly, to do the proposals that you have due, to get the emails done that you have to get done. So I started breaking things down. And once I did that and I realized the bad thought processes, or let's just say the unrealistic thought processes that I had a different understanding. Now, one of the things, the reason that I wanted to shoot this video, it's really kind of piggybacking or complementing that discovery, in that here's another thing I figured out about myself. And I know a ton of you guys have this, and it can be true for fitness, it can be true for work, it can be true for stuff around your house, okay? If you're like me, I hate this, but do you catch yourself going, that you, I always call it shiny object syndrome, that you're easily distracted, but you like so many things that you, and I know there's a phrase and I'm going to screw it up. They call it, you know, oh, something, 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 master of nothing. Like, you know, you try everything, but you don't ever really do anything fully. Or you become interested in this or that, or you start everything, but you don't ever really do anything fully. Now, let me put this in fitness terms. It's like with me, I've certainly done this in the past, and part of it is genuine interest in so many different things. Like, I want to do kickboxing. I want to do this Beachbody program. I want to do that. Oh, Kathy Friedrich has some new DVDs out. Oh my God, I want to go to the gym. I want to do that. I saw this on Instagram. I want to do that. And I get so like distracted by all of these sparkly lights and shiny objects. And then I have to look into everything, right? And then I'll buy a program. And then I'm like, well, I've got to figure this all out. I've got to plan this out. So if I'm going to do this program, what do I want to do? And then sometimes I probably am, I don't want to say I do anything on purpose, but I just get caught up. I get caught up in looking at too many things instead of just, I do this with books too. You know, I start 7 different books at a time and then I'm never finishing anything. And I went around my house, I was doing some house cleaning, and I found, you know, 2 books over there, 2 books over here. And sometimes it's like I get so excited because I'm so interested in reading. I have all these business books. Then I have all of these. I started, you know, forcing myself to read some non-business books, you know, personal books. And then I got so excited because I got these cool books. And I'm like, I love this book. And I'm like, I want to read that one. I want to read that one. And then I can't decide. So then I start to read so many of them. Then I get to my room at night and I open up my drawer, my bedroom drawer, the dresser drawer, and I'm like, wow, I forgot I started that book too. And then I started that book. And so I'm not finishing any of the books and I'm starting them all. And all of these processes that are going on at the same time, in a way, can then cause me like a tremendous amount of overwhelm, because then I'm stepping back going, oh my God, okay, so which book am I going to start? This is frustrating, you know, because I'm never going to finish all these books. Same thing with workouts. I catch myself doing the same thing. Whitney asked me to put together some, you know, kind of a list of different moves that I like, because she's going to design a bunch of circuits for me. And I'm already catching myself going, wait, because now I'm going, well, let me get all my DVDs out that I have. I've got to categorize them. I've got to get these to her and I've got to do this. Now there's one thing, you guys, let me just pause in the middle of this. There's one thing good to be said about planning. Okay. I've said that before and I'm going to talk about that in another video. I should really like maybe outline what I'm going to talk about. That would be good. Instead of just, you know, I thought this was going to be a 4-minute video. We're at the 9-minute mark. I got to shut up pretty soon. But it's very easy to become, and somebody write into me in the comments and tell me what that phrase is. Something, 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 master of nothing. There's a bird outside that's doing weird things. If you can catch yourself, like I just caught myself going, stop getting so distracted, Kelly. Pick one thing. You don't have to do everything now. You don't have to do every single amazing Beachbody program that you have. Like, I think I just got a new Shaun T cardio thing. And then I was like, oh my God, it's T25. Okay, T25's been out for a while. I got T25 and all of a sudden I saw something on YouTube and I'm like, oh my God, wait a minute. So when did this Max 30 come out? I've got to get Max 30. And I finally had to go, Kelly, do you know how many programs that you have at home? And you can't do them all. You can't do all of them at once. Like, it's okay, but that's also a bad problem of mine, impulsive spending. I'm gonna be working on that too. But do you guys find that you do that? I do it with work. I get into my office, and this is gonna be one of the number one things I'm working on, is channeling myself and getting myself to just do one thing at a time. I had started this year off and I was working on not multitasking. I'm doing that, but you know what else I do? I get into my office, I sit down, I say, I'm gonna do proposals. Start off on a proposal, someone texts me. Usually I have my phones turned off. But then I get on a call, then I do this, then I walk by my laundry and I start, you know, oh, let me just fold these clothes. And then I go over here, oh, let me just do some meal prep. Oh, I should just run to Walmart and do this. Another reason why I'm getting an assistant as soon as possible. But if you can see that you can get so scattered, so frazzled, and you start so many things, and because you never really focus, you're further off on the bad end of things than if you just focused on one thing and finished it well. That's what I'm focusing on. That makes a little bit of no sense. I am seeing this in myself, that this is a huge, probably one of the biggest things, that if I can really turn the ship around with myself, it's going to help in my fitness world, it's going to help in my business world, it's going to help not so much in my personal world. You know, in your personal world, you want to be like impulsive and spontaneous, I guess is the better word. But I'm curious if any of you guys have had that same habit of kind of starting a bunch of things and either never finishing it or never really giving one thing 100%, because I'm kind of feeling that it's time to give things 100%. 100% or nothing. And that's not a bad thing. You don't have to feel like, okay, if I give my focus to one thing, I'm never going to get other stuff done. That's a fear that's irrational that we all have to deal with. I'm realizing that I've been irrational about certain things. And again, I'm certainly not succeeding by trying to do everything all at once. I'm not succeeding by hurrying and rushing. I have to like chill out and realize there's certain lessons that I am having to learn over and over again because I haven't really addressed them completely. And guess what? That's what I'm doing now. Seriously, I came in here, didn't plan to shoot a video. I was getting ready to relax. That's what I'm gonna do now. But I shot this video for you so that you can be inspired and excited on your weekend to focus and stop multitasking and do things 100%. That's all. I gotta go.